Good day, guys. This is a discussion that would make Module 3 a little bit easier for us to tackle. Kasi meron dalawang points dito sa Module 3 na gusto ko i-discuss para mas madali ninyo ma-accomplish yung mga requirement, no? Incidentally, ang Module 3 kasi bridge ito going to Module 4. Kaya mapapansin ninyo, dito sa atin, wala tayong masyadong submissions na Module 3. No? Ang ginagawa lang ng Module 3, it is looking back at what you did in Module 2. No? Tapos, nagbibigay siya ng tips or activity para mas madali niyong magawa yung Module 4. Okay, so that's generally what Module 3 does. This is why you can actually notice na dito, meron tayong formative assessment pero hindi siya graded, no? If we're going to access this, makikita nyo dito na dito pa lang sa kaniyang title, formative assessment for LaSallian Service Plan. No, LaSallian Service Plan is in Module 5 and Module 4 is an introduction to Module 5. Didiscuss natin yan kapag gumawa ulit ako ng second discussion video. Pero suffice it to say, ang Module 3 kasi bridge. Okay? So walang masyadong isa-submit dito. However, there are two points that I want you to pay attention to, no? First, of course, ay ito ngang requirement na to na formative assessment. No? It leads us to answer this question. Number one, what is the social issue that we are passionate about? So generally, parang ito yung summary or review ng output ng Module 2. Remember, gumawa kayo ng song. Napuntahan nga natin yan. Nakinig kayo ng song. I'm sorry, hindi pala gumawa. Nakinig kayo ng song. And then you identified a certain social problem that resonates with the song, no? And then you did a group discussion for it. So, yun yung Module 2, no? Tingnan natin, parang para meron kayong konting recall. Excuse me. So, parang ito yun, ano? There was this instruction na pipili kayo ng song, no? Specific song that represents a social issue that has affected or disturbed you. Ito yung output ng Module 2. You remember, nagkaroon kayo ng discussion about it, tapos meron kayong ginawang parang roadmap or concept map, no? Kung saan nandoon yung LaSallian Reflection Framework. Tatandaan nyo yan, no? So, yan ang gagamitin ninyo para makuha ninyo yung material na gagamitin ninyo dito sa requirements ng Module 3. Incidentally, ang requirements ng Module 3 ay discussion. So, you are going to meet as a group and you are going to at least talk about these two, no, questions that is enumerated here. So, first, what is the social issue that we are passionate about? What do we know about this social issue? What led us to be concerned about this social issue? And why is there a need to respond to this social issue? And so on and so forth. So, you just answer in a form of discussion itong first and second question na to, no? Incidentally, ang second question ay, are there existing organizations that address the social issue? So, generally, parang mas hinihimay niya yung na-identify niyong social issue in Module 2. Now, I'm gonna give you a bit of a tip. Kapag ginawa niyo itong discussion na to, para madali niyong magawa yung mga output ng Module 4, mag-take notes kayo. It's either you try to record, no, your discussion, o kaya naman ay talagang ilista ninyo lahat na napag-usapan ninyo and then you summarize it later. Another tip na pwede ko ibigay para mas madali ninyong magawa itong mga requirements na to, no, Module 3 and Module 4, yung discussion ninyo, kung meron kayong notes doon sa Module 2, okay, you bring it with you here in your activity in Module 3. So, alam nyo na agad kung ano yung pag-uusapan. And then, right then and there, as you were answering this, halimbawa, dalawa kayo or tatlo, no, na gumagawa nito, or 9 in a group, makikita ninyo na dapat nagbabank kayo doon sa output ninyo ng module 2, tapos pupunta kayo dito sa module 3, you're going to right then and there take down notes. So yan ang mga tips sa inyo, dapat masummarize ninyo na mabuti, kasi lahat ng output na makukuha ninyo in your discussion here in this formative assessment, those are the same things that you are going to use in module 5. In module 5, incidentally, you are going to design a LaSallian service plan. Now, the LaSallian service plan centers around a social issue. So when you already have a social issue, when you already have summarized and discussed thoroughly a certain specific social issue that resonated with the group, then it would be very easy for you to design what you're going to do, what you're going to put out as a service plan in module 5. So yan. Okay, so number one na dapat niyong pay attention to very closely dito sa module 3 ay itong output na ito, no? Last point that I want you to get into ay itong instruction for module 4 na naka-embed dito sa module 3. Okay? So dito sa module 3, meron ditong preparation for module 4. Kasi, just to give you an idea, ang module 4 ay parang mag-a-analyze kayo ng case. So there is this LaSallian service plan that has been executed by some of the more community-oriented institutions in LaSalle. For example, yung mga organizations in LaSalle, no, like faculty and community service organizations, no, that went out and did a specific project for the community. Okay, naging community service ito and they documented what they did. Okay? So, yung mga documents na yon came and went into the 5 case analysis na makikita ninyo sa module 4, no? So makikita nyo dito sa module 4, if I may get there, meron ditong case analysis. I'm gonna discuss with you later kung paano nyo madaling magagawa itong case analysis na to. Pero dito sa module 3, suffice it to say, you need to look at a certain document for you to be able to analyze the case in module 4 better. So puntahan natin yan. What you can see here, what you can see here is that this preparation is leading you to a certain document, no? If I may show you kung ano yung document na yan, yan yung LaSallian guiding principles, no? So ito yun, ito yung actual na itsura ng document na yan. Medyo, this is a little bit sort of a not so very short of a read, kasi mahaba konti ito, no? Although parang 6 to 8 pages lang siya, pero maliliit. So ito yung LaSallian service plan. It is a document that is standard to all LaSallians, answering the questions who we are as LaSallians and what are we about. So makikita nyo dito sa document na ito yung a little bit of history ng LaSallian guiding principle, no? Kung ilan, anong year nagkaroon ng latest synod. Tapos, it delineates the core values, the content of our core values, yung service, yung faith, at saka yung sense of communion in mission. So, those are the components that is being discussed here in this document. Plus, syempre, may mga discussions about the current social involvement of the LaSallian community. If you want to actually make it a little bit easy, bibigyan ko kayo ng tip. Okay, bibigyan ko kayo ng parang one of the ways to make this part of the module a little bit easy. You just browse yung LaSallian guiding principle and try to watch this video by clicking this link. Meron kasing video explainer ang LaSallian guiding principle. So let me go there. So ito yung video explainer niya, no? You can see here that this video is actually leading you to a bit of the salient points, no? Salient points of the specific document, Lasallian guiding principles. So if you watch this video, it's more of like a summary of that document. Okay? So when you get this, hindi na masyadong magiging parang tough and impervious yung document na Lasallian guiding principle. Okay, so at least I hope you were able to get that. So yung dalawang bagay na gusto kong bigyan nyo ng attention, even though module 3 is a module that you do not have to submit anything, okay, to the Canvas, please pay attention to number 1, yung group discussion, and number 2, itong Lasallian guiding principle. Okay, so there, thank you for watching this video. I'm gonna make a short video, siguro ganito din kaikse, about module 4, explaining kung ano yung mga markers, at bibigyan ko rin kayo ng tip if ever kung paano nyo mapapadali going about the requirements of module 4. Thank you guys for watching, and see you on the next video. Good day.